Despite there being so many characters in Avengers Infinity War, Nakia was conspicuously absent from all the fighting. Rest assured that, according to the folks at Marvel, she's gone but not forgotten, and there are big plans for her in the future of the MCU. We'll take a look at the comic books for clues, but be warned that what we discover may surprise you. Let's just say that the Nakia we know isn't always on T'Challa's side. Strap in, folks. In the movie Black Panther, we learn that Nakia is a war dog specializing in espionage, but she's not a member of the Dora Milaje. She even resists putting on the Order's armor when Shuri offers it to her. But in the comics, Nakia has grown up a Dora, and let's not forget one of their controversial tasks. In the MCU, the Dora Milaje are charged with protecting the king, but in the comic books, they also serve as a dating pool for him. They're raised from childhood to serve the king in whatever way he requires and hope he'll select one of them to be his bride. If that description made you cringe a little bit, you're not alone. Producer Nate Moore described that aspect of the Dora Milaje as a little creepy and decided not to include it in Black Panther. Probably a good call?
Yeah.
In the movie, it seems as though Nakia has the upper hand in her relationship with T'Challa, despite him being a literal king. He can't help but freeze up around her, and it's clear she broke his heart when the two parted ways, but in the comic books, the two have a completely different dynamic. Nakia joined the Dora Milaje at age 14 and immediately became infatuated with the handsome king. She spent most of her time fantasizing about marrying him and creating elaborate ruses to get his attention. Even though she was trained to be a fierce warrior, she wasn't above flirting like a teenage girl. But T'Challa wasn't interested in Nakia, and instead had his sights on an American woman named Monica Lynn. The two fell in love, and you can probably imagine how well Nakia took the news that her king didn't want to marry her. Nakia offered a thank you next to her former crush, took some time to rediscover herself, and moved on in a healthy way. Just kidding. She straight up pushed Monica out of an airplane and told T'Challa she was dead. Surprisingly, this didn't make T'Challa any more interested in her. In fact, it inspired him to strip her of her status as a member of the Dora Milaje, causing her to be shunned by all of Wakanda. Developing feelings for someone had gone as badly as it possibly could have for Nakia, but at the end of the day, she had nobody to blame but herself. Of course, this didn't stop her from blaming others, namely T'Challa. Eventually, she ended up suffering at the hands of Achebe, one of Black Panther's many enemies, but she was rescued by none other than Eric Killmonger, who healed her and imbued her with a greater strength than she ever had before. By that we mean physical strength, because emotionally, she was still pretty much a mess. Killmonger also started calling her Malice, and she began a new career as a villain of the Black Panther. Not the best career move, but definitely a surprising one based on her role in the Black Panther movie. Is it possible we'll see Nakia go from exchanging smitten glances with T'Challa to going full-on Malice in the MCU? Actress Lupita Nyong'o, who plays Nakia, claims that she'd love to play a villain at some point in the near future, and when asked specifically about Nakia becoming Malice, she said, "Yes, sign me up." But there's one obvious problem with the MCU's Nakia turning into Malice. Right now, T'Challa is head over heels in love with her, and Nakia was the one who pulled the plug on their relationship in the first place. Killmonger won't be able to use her anger at T'Challa against him for two reasons. The first, and arguably most important of which, is that Killmonger is dead. We know we don't like to admit it either, but it's true. And the second is that she really has no reason to be angry at T'Challa at the moment, considering how Black Panther ended. They're in a good spot. But there's one thing that T'Challa does in the comic books which might just inspire MCU Nakia to turn against him. He marries someone else. No, it's not poor Monica who Nakia pushed out of a plane, but it's someone you might have heard of before. Her name is Aurora Monroe, but you probably know her as Storm. Up until recently, the rights of Storm and the rest of the X-Men belonged to Fox, which prevented them from appearing in the MCU. But now, Disney and Marvel Studios are able to introduce the X-Men into their universe, although we aren't sure exactly when this will happen. Sooner rather than later, nudge nudge. There are many cases of the movies not following the comic books, and the character of Nakia is just one example of this. But the relationship between T'Challa and Aurora is hugely important in the comic books, so it'd be surprising if it never happens in the MCU. Not only is Storm a powerful, much-beloved superhero in her own right, but she's also the leader of the X-Men, and has been involved with the Avengers and the Fantastic Four. This was one of those comic book events which even non-comic book fans took notice of when it happened. And it seems like some actors may be rooting for this to happen in the MCU as well. Alexandra Shipp portrays Storm in X-Men Apocalypse, and she'd love to see T'Challa and Storm get married on the big screen. She said that even if she isn't chosen to play Storm in the MCU, the important part is that the character ties the knot with Black Panther. But while Lupita Nyong'o likes the idea of becoming Malice, she also doesn't want to lose T'Challa. She says she feels territorial over her king and told Chadwick Boseman to watch out if that happens. Sorry, Lupita, but you can't have it both ways. If you're gonna see Nakia turn into Malice, it means T'Challa is gonna have to find love with someone else. There's another option for the future of Nakia, and it's a much more cheerful option than having her turn evil. At the end of Black Panther, we see T'Challa create the Wakandan International Outreach Center and appoint Nakia the head of their social outreach department. Nakia has been working for years to help her fellow Wakandans, and now she has an institutionalized way to do just that. This not only sets up a resource for people in the MCU, but could potentially be setting up a new way for fans to enjoy their favorite Marvel characters. In addition to all the great movies created by Marvel Studios, there are also many television shows based on Marvel characters. While these movies and shows take place in the same universe, some fans prefer not to acknowledge the shows when thinking about the overall timeline of the MCU. Here at CBR, we respect your personal MCU headcanon, but there's no use in pretending that these shows don't exist at all. Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., Daredevil, and Agent Carter, just to name a few, have tons of fans who can't get enough of them. And many believe the end of Black Panther was opening up the possibility for yet another show utilizing Marvel characters. Black Panther was not only a great movie, it was a profitable one, taking in over $1 billion and breaking box office records. Not to mention that Oscar nod. Big deal. It also helped introduce a whole new world of moviegoers, and based on the amount of money the movie has made, it seems they enjoyed it. Disney has already made an animated show called Black Panther, which is available on Marvel's YouTube channel. One of the challenges we see T'Challa grappling with is deciding where to focus his attention. Of course, there's Wakanda, but there's some villains who aren't threatening Wakanda specifically yet and wreaking havoc on the world at large. It's up to T'Challa to decide how to allocate resources and himself in these situations. We assume this theme is one which will play out at many points in the MCU, from the inevitable Black Panther 2 and beyond. But one thing which might help out T'Challa is having someone like Nakia out there making a difference in the world. The MCU version of Nakia is brave, clever, and let's not forget, headstrong. We also know she's willing to put her loyalty to Wakanda above her personal desires. This makes her the perfect candidate for spearheading the Wakandan outreach program and possibly starring in her own television show, huh? Nakia, Shuri, and Okoye were all immensely popular characters, but we don't exactly see Okoye leaving Wakanda or the King's side. The existence of Wakanda opened up so many possibilities that even the expansive MCU might not be able to do it justice. It may take a separate show in order to utilize all of the interesting plot lines, characters, and places from the comic books. Why do we think Nakia specifically should be the one to lead the future of the Black Panther franchise? Let's just take a look at her part in the movie. On the surface, it seems as though the majority of the conflict was a clash between T'Challa and Eric Killmonger. T'Challa was determined to protect Wakanda by maintaining its secrecy and utilizing its resources to those who lived within its borders. Killmonger also had ideas, and he wanted to protect people outside of Wakanda by waging war and fighting against those who oppressed them. However, Nakia had a much more sensible viewpoint than either of these two characters. She knew Wakanda had the resources to help people outside of its borders, and wasn't naive enough to believe that this could be done without a cost. Still, she believed the rewards to be worth the risks. Instead of waging war like Killmonger wanted to do, she wanted to use Wakanda's considerable resources in a peaceful way. Nakia represented a middle ground between hiding like T'Challa and starting a battle like Killmonger. T'Challa didn't do what Nakia wanted at the end of the movie just because he was hoping for a kiss. He did so because he realized she was right the whole time. And that's way more romantic than a simple smooch. She's a true revolutionary, and unlike Killmonger, her plans aren't short-sighted and mired in violence. People call into question her loyalty because she's a spy, but Nakia went above and beyond to protect her people when things went badly. She was the one who got Queen Ramonda and Shuri to safety, and had the bright idea to preserve a powerful herb for later use. When she's given the opportunity to consume it herself, thus obtaining a massive amount of power, she declines. How many of us would honestly say no to free superpowers? I'd totally say yes. Nakia isn't in this for selfish reasons or personal gain. She wants to do what's best for Wakanda, even when it seems as though it's falling apart. Nakia proves she's already a hero when she offers to give the herb to M'Baku so that he can utilize his army in order to help Wakanda. Of course, it turns out T'Challa was alive and able to benefit from Nakia's quick thinking and selfless loyalty to his kingdom. Nakia's voice may not have been the loudest during Black Panther, but it was the most often correct, and it was thanks to her that T'Challa was saved so that he could finally act on what she had been saying for ages. Considering that Nakia is such an important character, why wasn't she there during Avengers Infinity War? Both she and Wakabi were conspicuously absent, and their disappearance went unacknowledged. According to producer Nate Moore, this isn't because Marvel forgot about them or anything like that. Leaving them out of Infinity War was an intentional move, and you may be seeing them sooner than you think. Avengers Endgame is going to have a lot going on, but we'll see the good people of Wakanda scrambling to deal with the fallout of T'Challa's passing. Nakia has a history of acting as a spy, plus she's supposed to be overseeing the new outreach program, so it makes sense that she wasn't in Wakanda during the events of Infinity War. It seems like the only movie we can think about lately is Avengers Endgame, but let's not forget that Marvel Studios is also working on a sequel to Black Panther. Marvel likes to keep their movie secrets close in order to build up hype for their upcoming projects, so we don't expect to see too much information on Black Panther 2 before Endgame comes out. Plus, whatever happens during Endgame may have a huge impact on the movie, so giving away info could also mean giving away spoilers, and who'd want that? Well, besides us, of course. Ryan Coogler will be back to direct Black Panther 2, and definitely feels the pressure to recreate the magic of the first film. Of course, we can't wait to see Lupita Nyong'o reprise her role as Nakia in this movie. Although Marvel hasn't given us a release date yet, you can probably expect to see Black Panther 2 hit theaters in 2020 or 2021. After learning about the comic book history of Nakia, what do you think this means for her future in the MCU? Do you think we're going to get to see Malice on the big screen? Let us know in the comments section below, and don't forget to subscribe to CBR for more MCU content. Thanks for watching.